This is the Belfast War Memorial Museum. This is the only museum in Belfast that deals with the Blitz and what happened to the streets of Belfast during the Blitz. Kerry, just describe what we're seeing here then.
So this corner of the museum talks about the Blitz, the raids on Belfast in April and May of 1941. The raids were completely unexpected. And Belfast was really underprepared, ill-equipped to handle the raids. I was actually speaking to one man who was based locally in the city centre the night of the raids, and the only preparation that he had was a bucket of sand, and he was told if there's a fire because of a raid, throw the sand over it, and there you go, that's your job. So he was completely ill-prepared. But over the course of April, May 1941, 1,000 lives were lost.
Right.
A number more were injured.
Whereabouts was mainly hit?
Well, because the second raid on Easter Tuesday, they were aiming for the docks but got confused with the waterworks, the bombs really fell in residential areas. So North Belfast, the Antrim Road, Percy Street was completely wiped out.
Percy Street, yeah.
You'll see if you wanted to scroll around, here on the wall there is a permanent scroll of names of those people that were lost during the Blitz. It's about to start up again and it runs alphabetically. So you'll see the surname, the name. Sometimes you get one or two, sometimes you get whole families, and then their age in brackets. Underneath you'll see the street where they were killed and on what day.
Well, I'm just a wee bit confused about this because you tell us that they were ill prepared, but yet Belfast was producing aircraft Belfast was a base for the military. So why were they so ill prepared?
Well, they didn't actually expect it to happen. I mean, Germany didn't really approach the north coast of Europe until 1940, and
right.
Then it was started to be taken more seriously. But up until 1939, Belfast was really seen as not of strategic importance to Germany at all, although it was very much to the UK. Obviously, we had a lot of the air bases here, and a lot of training happened here for the British and the American servicemen.
Yeah, right. And somebody told me that Belfast, to their knowledge, was the second most bombed city in the UK after London.
That's true, yes.
That's true.
That is.
So there's no other city in the UK had more than 1,000 casualties, deaths.
I'm not too sure of the statistics, but I know that it's all relative. How do you think about it in terms of housing stock? Half of the housing stock in Belfast was completely wiped out.
Half of the housing stock was wiped out, right?
Yeah.
My goodness.
Destroyed.
My goodness, I just couldn't believe that whenever I heard it, because you never hear of Belfast, you hear of Coventry.
Yeah, that's it, that's one of the bigger ones. But Belfast, it was the second largest outside of
London. Right, okay. Dear, oh, and many of those people would have been buried up in the city hospital.
In the city cemetery. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But, after the raids, a number of the bodies were rolled out, laid out in St George's Market and the Arnold Baths, Baths and Falls for identification.
They tried to identify them.
And
those that weren't identified were put into a common grave.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Milltown City Cemetery.
Right. Yeah. And I think it was City as well. Standing in front of the centrepiece, and I've got Kerry, one of the curators here, to keep me right about things. Kerry, who and what is this particular sculptor all about?
So this piece was commissioned by the museum in 2009. John Sherlock was the sculptor. It's cast in bronze. It was cast from or made from a life-size model of a mother and her child. The title is Blitz Survivors. So really this is meant to portray a mother leading her daughter through the ruins of Belfast the day after the first the Blitz, the raid on the town. So you can see a lot of details in the piece.
Yes.
But one thing that isn't obvious straight away, this is probably the best part of the sculpture, which contextualises the piece and gives it its date, is the newspaper that you will see here.
Oh, right.
It was the original Northern Whig newspaper with the headline 200 Feared Dead, and it was cast in bronze and put in the piece just to give it the date and that link to the Blitz.
Right.
But there's so much else within the piece that is just, it makes it so valuable to the museum and the kids that come in. and they love to see it. Not only have you got the mother and the child, but even the way the mother is dressed. She's wearing a traditional
low-worker's uniform of the day.
So someone who'd have worked in Mackie's or ammunitions or textile factories of the day, this would be her. Even her hairstyle is down to the period. You have the vintage robe and the shoes, leading into the young girl who is wearing what you would see a lot of children in the 1940s wearing. She's carrying her teddy bear, which is flung at the back there.
Yes.
Can relate to that.
Yes.
But even down to the cobblestones. So this is the Dublin Fire Brigade 1941 helmet, which is on short-term loan, very kindly, from the Dublin Fire Brigade themselves.
Right.
It's a cork helmet. And it is the helmet that would have been worn by the fire service who came up to Belfast in 1941 and over 3 days helped put out all of the fires and any of the debris. They shifted that after the Blitz.
So they came up and helped our fellows deal with the aftermath of the bombing.
They did indeed, yeah.
And